Yo, YouTube, what's crackin' like a jack of smack, and it's Waffle Man back with a video. And tonight's the night. In about a couple of minutes at 8 p.m. Eastern time, the 2K Combine qualifiers will officially start. Unfortunately, I won't be able to actually play because it's only from 8 p.m. to 12 a.m. I actually thought you could play anytime, but they actually have a schedule. If you got 50 wins from before in January, you will have that freaking menu screen on the menu in 2K18. And when you click on it, it gives you the schedule of dates you can actually play to get your 40 games of minimum play. So there's one today, there's one on Saturday, tomorrow, 2 p.m. to I think 8 p.m. And on Sunday again, which is Super Bowl Sunday, which I hope the Eagles win, they're gonna have another 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. So I won't be able to play today, but I'll hopefully play tomorrow, 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. I'm not gonna play all of those hours, of course. And then we got Sunday, which is Super Bowl Sunday, so I probably won't be able to play then. And then I think we got, Wednesday, which, you know, I don't have class on Wednesday, so I'll be here Wednesday, but I still won't be able to play that much. And then Friday again. So mainly the main days are Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So you gotta look at that schedule and plan accordingly if you want to get your 40 games played. Now, I will say this. They also said, that's confirmed, that by April, you must relocate. If you are drafted by the 2K E-League, which is the draft takes place in March, you must relocate. I don't know, they didn't give a specific date, but they said somewhere in April. So you're going to be moving to that city. So listen, hopefully if you have work, you canceled all your work that month or whatever, because once you do the E-League, man, that's going to be it for the next couple of months. That's what you're going to be doing every single day, daily. They're going to give you food, they're going to give you housing. That's what you're going to be doing. You're going to be practicing. It's a real life thing, man. So if you got classes, that's done. You're taking college courses right now, that's done. That should have been shut down. You would have been wasting your college tuition for no reason, and you would have wasted all your work days for no reason or whatever. But once you do this 2K E-League, it's over. So 72,000 people qualified, and out of all those people, they still got to determine whether you're 18 or older. And then they have to do background checks and also do a drug test. It's some serious business, man. I mean, it's just like the NBA. So they're going to do a background check, they're going to do a drug test. So don't be smoking that weed, don't be doing any drugs, you know what I'm saying? You know, yeah, I ain't going to say anything on this channel, but you know what I'm saying? By the time it's April, make sure you're off anything you're taking, man. It's time to sober up. But I finally figured out which build I'm going to be using. I'm not sure if you can go back in or change your build or use different builds at the same time. We don't know that yet, man. We don't know if there's going to be hotspots for these players. We don't know what type of badges we're going to have for these players. You know, all we know is that we're going to be giving a player. We know the height, we know the weight, which I will explain later. But I will probably be using the build you see on the screen right now. My Super Saiyan God Slashing Shot Creator. Now, this is a point guard, and the slashing shot creator they have is that shooting guard, but I should still be fine because that's the second fastest build in that shooting guard tier. So I should be fine, man. And I've been used to playing this build at point guard, which honestly isn't that fast when you think about it, because when you compare it to other, you know, playmaking builds at the point guard position, they have a higher speed with ball. They can really blow past me, and it's not like I'm super, super fast, but it's still going to be a great build at the shooting guard position. And the other build I wanted to use was probably the pure rim protector, because that's going to be cheese as well, in my opinion. But we got some big news on the height and the weight. Now, I will have this posted up on the screen, but they gave the preset heights and weights for each of the positions. And of course, as usually, people got butthurt again. Point guard, we got 6'3", 190 pounds. That's typical. That's a typical PG in this game. 6'3", 190. That's actually most of my point guard builds. I mean, that's typical. Shooting guard, 6'6", 210. Again, pretty typical, pretty standard, even though I only have a 6'5 shooting guard, but it's still pretty standard. Small forward, 6'8", 230. Standard. Makes sense. Just like similar to some people in the NBA like Carmelo, even though LeBron James, accordingly, he's weighed at 250. I don't believe that, though. Power forward, 6'11. I mean, shit, I got a 6'11 athletic finisher who's around 240, 242. So all of this right now is standard, you know what I'm saying? And center, 7'1, 260. Now, some people got hurt for a couple of reasons. One, of course, you know there's some point guards running around in 2K that are 6'7", max weight. I mean, it's just, it's hilarious. Those guys kind of got tight. And then, of course, the bigger issue that some people have an issue with is the 7'3", maxed, you know, maxed weighted players, man. And like I said, man, every time my athletic finisher plays a center position and he's put against one of these 7'3 rebounding athletics or even post scoring athletics or post scorers, the reason he gets dominated is because these guys have such a high weight, they're just backing me down. Now, I don't know what their strength is because I haven't used that build. I don't know what their strength is even included with that weight. But those guys are hard to stop if you don't have a pure rim protector or some type of defender in the paint. And then if you don't have the right weight, you're going to just get backed down the whole game. And that's what was happening to my athletic finisher. That's why I made him a power forward, of course. But it still sometimes puts you at center, of course, because you're playing with random people on pro-am sometimes. But you understand what I'm saying. So people got kind of upset at that. But you got to realize this is the first time they're doing something like this to 2K E-League. And with all that being said, it's got to be standard, man. I mean, especially for the combine, I don't know if it's going to change for the actual league itself. But for the combine, in order to find skill, you have to level out every single player. You have to level everything out. Everyone's got to be on the same type of builds, the same weight, the same height. That's how you find skill. You can't just give someone a better build because, you know, some people, just anyone could really have a better build than 2K. There's some people that you know you see when you face them, you have a better build than them. You know it when you see that build. If you got a playmaking shot creator at 6'3 and you're facing some type of what, sharpshooting defender at point guard, you know your build is probably better than theirs, especially if they got the wrong height or the wrong wingspan or even the wrong weight. So people been making bad builds for a long time. Even some of my builds back in 2K17 were pretty bad. I mean, maybe not that bad, but they were all pretty useful to use, even though some builds can definitely be better than others. So, and all that being said, we got all the information. Now it's time to play. I'm gonna have a video up tomorrow showing this the slashing shot creator build that they give us, and I'm gonna use it and see how it is, man, because listen, it's definitely going to feel a lot different. It's going to feel a lot slower than my point guard slashing shot creator build. But let me know if you qualify and if you're playing. Let me know what build you're using. And if you hope to actually get into the 2K E-League. Of course, I'm not getting into the 2K E-League. I'm not going to try to get drafted. I'm going to play a couple games, see how it is. But of course, you know, I mean, I got college, man. So I'm not trying to do none of this 2K stuff. But I just like to bring you guys news and keep you up to date with what's going on. But anyways, man, leave a like for more. I'm out for now. Peace.